Hello, in this video I'm going to be teaching you some of the most common errors that people make when applying for a CHEVNU scholarship. We all know that the CHEVNU scholarship is a scholarship by the United Kingdom government for CHEVNU eligible countries. Not all countries are eligible, but probably your country will be available. So here are some of the most common mistakes that people actually make when applying for a CHEVNU scholarship. First and foremost, CHEVNU scholarship actually gives you a pre-screen test, and in this pre-screen test, if you don't pass it, they would not pass your application to those that are going to check your essay, that are going to check if you are qualified based on what you the information you provided or not, because the pre-screen test is very, very important. Most of what is in the pre-screen test is actually about your, maybe you have a connection with the royal family, maybe you've actually previously won a scholarship with the British government. If that actually is applicable to you, they wouldn't give you the scholarship, and most people just rush to the application process, and then they just pick yes to a question that they're supposed to choose no, and then they fail the eligibility test, and so their application is not passed across. Of course, there are some times that you might fail the eligibility test, but you have three options to actually write it, and if you fail the third time, then you have to apply again the next time. So on the pre-screen test, you have to be very careful that you actually choose the correct answer. So I don't see any reason for you to actually rush through your application. That's why it's very important to start early. I don't mean submit early, I mean start early. They are not going to actually process the applications until the closing date. It was around November that the applications will be processed. So everybody that's submitting is actually being stored in archive. So you have to take your time, start early, and then reread your application, reread your document, make sure you do everything very well. You don't need to rush it. So that's one thing. And you know, one thing I used to say about for you to win a scholarship, that you need all the information that you can get. You have to browse a lot of information. People that win scholarship can attest to this. You have to browse, go through a lot of information, read everything readable about the application. And also, you also have to be careful too, because there are many quack informations out there that will, rather than help you, that they will actually do more damage. So you have to be careful on that too. And that's another mistake that people make. People take information from a lot of sources that are not actually eligible. People who just want subscribers, people who just want people to follow them, and then give wrong information rather than the right information. So you have to be careful where you get your information as well. And then also, on the application form, you must complete every part of the application form to be considered eligible. Sometimes some people just go to some part of the application, they didn't fill all the application, because CHEVNU is talking about leadership. They want to see you as a coordinated leader, and so one of the things that show is the way you actually approach your application. It's not about doing it, it's also about how you did it. So you have to be careful to make sure you fill all the parts of the application form as well. And then also, one of the mistakes that people make is that sometimes they actually choose that, oh, they have dual citizenship. You must indicate that you don't have a dual citizenship. Applicants who indicate they have dual citizenship from the United Kingdom cannot be considered for an award. Of course, if you have dual citizenship which is not connected to the UK, it doesn't affect you. But you know, if you have dual citizenship with United Kingdom, you won't be considered for the scholarship. And one mistake that people make too is that many people have more than 2 years experience, but what they actually calculate majorly in that experience is the hours that you worked. So you just have to show, oh, you must have worked for 2 years, and then that 2 years, it must be at an equivalent of 2,000, minimum of 2,800 hours. So you can't just put 2 years and then maybe in the numbers, you know, they will ask you that how many hours do you work per week, and then you put just any any number, and maybe when they calculate the number in years, then you are not able to meet up. That will actually disqualify you. You have to be able to, you have to make sure that you calculate the minimum requirement of 2,800 hours over a period of 2 years. You have to make sure that you actually put what is actually right there. And you know, one mistake that some people make here too is that they put exaggerated hours. They exaggerate the hours, that some might say they work 200 hours per week. No, don't put it that way, that you work 200 hours per week. You can't work 200 hours per week. So you have to make sure that everything you put in your work experience is realistic. The system will automatically calculate the hours that you work. A working year, the way they calculate a working year is actually like 40 to 50 weeks. So you have to make sure that you actually put in the numbers of the time you work in a week, because sometimes maybe some weeks, some works require to work 2 times a week. They wouldn't know. So you have to put it there that, okay, this is the numbers of time that you work in a week, and you make sure that, okay, this, well, you have to calculate it yourself to make sure you meet the minimum. And also you have to make sure that you don't enter, you don't duplicate your work experience. Maybe you put, I work in so-so position here, then you put for this hour, for this week, for this numbers of days of the week, and then you enter another one, and then you put the same information just to make sure that you actually meet the minimum requirements. That will actually disqualify you. And also you have the opportunity of selecting 3 different courses. And so most times some people still make a mistake by actually duplicating courses at the same university. For example, I choose linguistics in Cambridge University, and then when it's time to for me to actually put in, oh, what is the second choice, because they on the application form you will have to fill, oh, these are the 3 courses that you picked, and these are the university that you picked them from. So some applicants make a mistake of actually just picking maybe just one course, maybe linguistics, and then they will now duplicate the linguistic 3 times just to make sure that they feel what the application is requiring of them. That's actually a very big mistake that can deem you ineligible. You have to select 3 different courses, and these courses must be similar. If they are not similar, it will actually give a point as maybe you don't know what you are doing, or you don't even know where you are going. So your course may be similar. Maybe you have, oh, you want to do communication, then you can, oh, digital communication, visual communication. And you can also maybe choose the same courses, but it must be in different universities. So, but you don't duplicate your course just to make sure that you fit the application procedure. No, don't duplicate your course. And then on the declaration as well, the section of the application form requires the applicant to correctly answer a number of statements to be considered eligible. If an applicant is not able to confirm that these statements apply to them, they will be deemed ineligible. You know, applicants are asked to think carefully and select maybe one of the 2 questions against each other, maybe yes or no. For example, you have to confirm that you are not employed by the British royal family, or you don't have any family that is employed, or maybe in the last 4 years or so with the royal family. You know, all those kind of questions, you just have to calm down in the declaration part of the application. You have to calm down. This is another mistake that people make. In the declaration part of the application, you have to calm down and make sure you pick yes when yes, where yes is applicable to you, and you also pick no when no is applicable to you. In the declaration, if you actually miss one of the questions, you'll be deemed ineligible for it. And also application, one of the mistakes that people also make is application word count. Sometimes people don't meet the minimum word count in their essay question. The minimum word count is 100 and the maximum word count is 500 words. So you want to make sure that you meet the minimum word count. If you don't meet the minimum word count, your application will be deemed ineligible as well. So you have to be careful. And I don't even think if you actually write an acceptable, because you know they grade your essays, they grade all the 4 essays that you are going to write, they give it points. And you know, one of the things that make them to give you points is that, okay, you've actually exhaustively actually talk about what you need to talk about. Of course, it's not in Chevney, it's not about quantity, it's about quality. But your quality that doesn't have quantity as well, it's deemed not to be quality sometimes. That is, you must exhaustively explain what you meant. I'm not saying you should list your achievements, just list all of them or list a lot of things in bullet points and give it all to them. But you just need to select maybe one or two. And that one or two that you select that you want to talk about, you must expand exhaustively on them. That, okay, this is what you do, this is how you do them, this is the results that you get from them, and this is the outcome of it. So that is just it. But you, if you do all this, if you answer these four questions, like, okay, this is what you do, this is how you do them, this is the situation, this is how you approach it, this is the manner you use in approaching it, and these are the results, you will actually write more than 100 words. So you must not write below the minimum 100, and you mustn't write as well beyond the expected, the maximum 500. And then also one thing that actually make a lot of people actually fail it is repetition. You might think you will not do it, but this actually something that many people actually do. Repetition. You should not actually, you know, you shouldn't, applicants should not repeat answers to any of the essay questions and should enter new and original answers for each of the four questions. You should not copy and paste the same answers into more than one box, as this will make the application invalid. You shouldn't copy maybe your leadership essay and put it in your network essay. No, you should, leadership and network actually sometimes they interface between each other, but you shouldn't actually put the same thing in, okay, that is your leadership essay, and then put the same thing as well in your networking essay. And then one thing also is plagiarism. You know, all applications that you submit to the system actually run through plagiarism software, which compares content against online sources. So if you actually copy your content online, so don't pass through the system, the system is going to detect it. So you want to make sure your content are original, and applicants are allowed to insert quotations too, but you must acknowledge the source as they would in an academic essay. You can actually quote, but you must acknowledge them as you would in an academic essay. So make sure your content are original. And then use of English, you must use English language. And one thing too that I want to say lastly is your grammar. Make sure you check your grammar very well. One of the ways they also grade your point is the usage of your grammar. You don't need to give them big words, you don't need to impress them with your big words, but just simple and clarity. Just be simple and clear. So that's what you need, and use the right grammar. So that is it. Those are the common mistakes that people make.